you know, people say stay positive, et cetera. It's not really, and people have said that about me, about to stay positive, et cetera. But then when I start talking about how I'm going to die someday, and they're like, well, no, you have to stay positive. It's like, that's not a negative thing to say, though, to me, for me. That's not, I am staying positive, but positive is just too wide. It's just too, I like to use humor. That's interpreted as being positive. Sometimes it can be very dark. Yeah. I won't, I'll hold back for this particular segment. Unless one slips out, we'll see. And it's, I try to disarm with humor. I think that's a big component of humor, and why I think it's important is that it disarms people. Disarms people, but it disarms yourself as well. It gives people permission to not take it so seriously. And it gives yourself permission as well. Not necessarily, you know, laughing about the situation, but, you know, laughing about anything, really. Because it does also affect you physically. It affects you physically. It's stuff with the heart and everything. I'm not a biologist, I was a mathematician. So it calms you down. It gives you a nice little burst of energy, and then it calms you down. Distracts your brain a little bit as well. There's something to be said about distractions and avoidance, avoiding thinking about it. There's people say, oh no, you can't do that. But yeah, you can. Yeah. You can go out and have a good time. You can allow yourself to do that. Just like you can allow yourself to laugh at things. Laugh at your situation. You know? I'm gonna be on my deathbed and I'm gonna be cracking jokes. You can bet you. Bet your ass? That's an expression, right? Yeah. You can bet your ass I'll be cracking jokes on my deathbed. That's something to be said about crying too. Crying is super healthy. Laughing is too. I like laughing better. But I try to leave room for both in my life.